Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing few details about how to post a specific ledger entry here when it comes to preparation of ledger balances. So we'll understand in detail about the steps of it. Let's figure that out. So when we speak about ledger balance, we have already understood how the specimen of that specific ledger account looks like. We know that there are four columns, each side, that is on the debit side as well as on the credit side. So when we speak about each side, debit balance and credit balance, we also talk about how the steps are supposed to be followed. We have already mentioned down the steps. Let's figure out in detail about how to go ahead with specimen or formatting or preparation of ledger account balances or the rules towards posting. The first step. Now the first step is to locate the account title with the journal entry that has been mentioned. So when you have to transfer the specific amount or the specific transaction to the ledger balance, you need to mention the account title itself. Now when you talk about account title, it has been mentioned in the journal entry. So every journal entry has two specific accounts or dual aspect follows. Or when we talk about dual aspect method, we always talk about two accounts being debited and credited. So one account being debited, one account being credited. Each account has a specific account title that has to be matched to that specific ledger account which has been prepared. Now this is the first step that you have to follow. Let's figure out what is the step two. The second step is to mention or to figure out whether it's a debit entry or a credit entry. So if it's a debit entry or credit entry, will further determine the course of action towards preparation of ledger balances. If it is a debit entry, it will be mentioned on the debit side of the ledger balance. If it is a credit entry, it will be mentioned on the credit side of the ledger balance. So debit account, debit side, credit account, credit side. So if the journal entry states cash account debit to goods account, cash is on the debit side, goods is on the credit side, goods will be mentioned on the credit side of goods account, cash will be mentioned on the debit side of cash account. This is how the account title differentiation and the debit or credit is measured here. Let's figure out the step three. As discussed in the earlier video, you need to figure out the date of the transaction. So when we talk about the date of the transaction, be very specific about the year. If the year or if it relates to the first entry itself, you have to mention the year on the top side of the date column, both on the debit and credit side. Afterwards, you need to figure out whether you're mentioning the subsequent entries related to the same year or not. If there isn't the change of the year, then the moment you go ahead with the preparation of ledger balances, the moment you change the year, you have to mention that year entries now. So you have to mention the year again on the top left and top right hand side under the date column. In between, if at all you're going on the fresh page again, that means you have mentioned down all the ledger balances on one page and then you go on to the next page. So in such scenarios also, it's better to have the year on the top left and the top left corner of both debit and credit side of the T account. This will ensure that you are in alignment with the year and there is no confusion while mentioning down the dates. So this will help you in further clarification. This was step three. Let's figure out the step four, which will be on the next sheet. Step 4 refers to writing down a brief description about the explanation or the transactions which you are referring to. As we know that we write down narrations below every journal entry, the same way we have to mention down the explanation which refers to that specific transaction. Now that explanation can be the brief narration about or a short note on that. So it's just a small line which will give you a description about what kind of transaction it is. That will be under the explanation column. We have already spoken about date, explanation, journal foreign and amount column in the previous video. Now we'll be understanding what all details are supposed to be mentioned in that. Now this is step 4. Let's figure out the step 5th. Now, as we know that there is a debit entry, there is a credit entry. So every debit entry will be mentioned on the debit side. Every credit entry will be mentioned on the credit side. Accordingly, you also need to mention the amount simultaneously in line with them. So when you mention the specific date, explanation besides it, you have to also mention the amount in line with it, which will give you a complete closure on that specific journal entry being posted into ledger. So once you mention down the journal folio, once you mention down the amount, you need to further analyze that this is the complete closure of the journal entry. That means the journal entry has been completely posted now into ledger and then can be further used for closure of ledger accounts and then preparation of trial balance. So this you have to mention. It is the same that you have to follow on the debit and credit side as well. There's no bifurcation in them. Let's figure out the last step when it comes to rules to posting. As we know that we have spoken about folio, that means the journal folio, which is the page number from which the journal transaction has been taken into consideration. So if you have the mentioned folio number in the question, you can always write down that folio number under the JF column or the F column in the ledger. So this will give you a brief clarification about how the journal entry is then formatted or transformed into a ledger account. That means first the date, second the explanation, third the amount, and the journal folio is supposed to be mentioned in line with every specific transaction that you do. So in the next video, we'll be able to understand how the specific illustration will help you to prepare a journal entry and then prepare a ledger balance of the same. So we'll be doing an illustration as well as we'll be doing further details on how to prepare the specific journal entries and then prepare the ledger balances for the same. So in this video, we have understood how and what are the rules of how to prepare the specific details on ledger preparation. So this is what we had to explain in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.